Today our topic is verb. Verb is the most important part of a sentence because no sentence is formed without verb. So verb means kriya. Kriya means kaaj. Kriya means kaaj. You have already learned that doing words are called verb, isn't it? Doing words are called verbs. Today we will learn a verb is a word which denotes being, having, or doing something, or doing something. Look at denotes means indicate, nirdesh kora. Indicates, that is nirdesh kora. Being means hoa. Being means hoa. Having means thaka ba ache. Doing means kora. That is, a verb is a word, kriya ba kaj ekti shobdo kriya, jeti nirdesh kore kichu hoa, kichu thaka ba kichu kora. Look at being. First, being. Being indicates what a person or thing is. Look at what a person or thing is. I am a teacher. I am a teacher. So, am means hoa. So being also hoa. So am, it is verb. So it means, that is, ami hoi shikshak. So am hoa. If I say you are students, tumra hoa chhatro. So are also means hoa. So being hoa. So are verb. She is an engineer. She's an engineer. So is means hoa. So that is verb. So am, are, is, that is verb. And it all indicates, that is, what a person or thing is. Thing, look at, if I say the car is a thing, the car is white. So gari ti hoa shada. So is hoa, that is gari shada hoa ta hoche is. So is, it is verb. Look at now having. Having, it is thaka. Having indicates what a person or thing has. Look at I have a doll. I have a doll. So have means thaka ba ache. So have, having, that is have, it is verb. Okay, you have a car. You can write down, she has a book. She has a book. So have, has, that is verb. Have, has indicates what a person or thing has. Now doing. Doing indicates what a person or thing does. Doing indicates what a person or thing does. Look at I teach you. What do I do, or what is my work? My work is teach, that is, teach you. My work is to teach you. So teach, it is verb. So he goes to school. Goes. What does he do? He goes to school. That is goes. It is doing verb. So goes verb. She also writes. She also writes. So writes, that is verb. What does she do? That is she writes. Look at, that is am, are, is, have, has, teach, goes, writes, all are verbs. Because all these verbs indicates or denotes being, having or doing something. So, we can tell a verb is a word which denotes or indicates being, having or doing something. Okay. Now, we will read kinds of verbs. There are so many kinds of verbs. But we will read just two kinds in standard 4. That is principal verb and auxiliary verbs. We just read principal verb and auxiliary verb. Principal means main. Principal means main. So principal verb we can tell also that is main verb. Or auxiliary means shajjokari. Auxiliary verb means helping verb. That is helping verb. Auxiliary verb, that is helping verb. Okay, now look at the sentences. Karim is a boy. So here we have already learned that is, it is verb. So I have a book, have, it is verb. So they play football, play, that is verb. Look at here, in this sentences, that is noun, verb, article, noun. So it is pronoun, verb, article, noun. That is pronoun, verb, noun. Look at here in this sentence is, and here this sentence have, and in this sentence play. These verbs use independently without any help of other verbs. So they are called principal verb or main verbs. They are called principal verb or main verbs. Look at in these sentences. Karim is reading a book. So you got there two verbs. So I have lost the book. So have and lost. Here you have got they are playing football. Verb is are and playing. Look at the sentences. In this sentence is, have and are help the main verb. They help the main verb. That is in the is help the main verb reading. Have helps the main verb lost and are helps the main verb playing.
Is, have, are auxiliary verbs. And reading, lost, playing principal verbs.
Now, so what can we tell the definition of principal verb? So definition of principal verb is that principal verb, the verbs which are used independently without help from other verbs are called principal verbs. And now look at auxiliary verbs. Auxiliary, that is most important, we have to learn it. And and auxiliary verb is a verb, is a verb which helps principal verb, which help principal verb to form tense, mood or voice. That is voice. That is an auxiliary verb, is a verb which helps principal verb to form a tense, mood or voice. So, form a tense, mood or voice. Now look at the sentence. Karim is reading a book. This sentence is written. This sentence is written in present continuous tense. And if I write, that is Karim reading, if I, without the helping verb is, if I write Karim reading a book, that will not be a correct sentence. To make this is in present continuous tense, I need the helping verb is. Look at this sentence. I have lost the book. This sentence is written in present perfect tense. So I need to present perfect, to make the present perfect tense, I need the auxiliary verb have. So it is also written present, the sentence, it is also written in present continuous tense. To make the tense, I need the auxiliary verb are. So an auxiliary verb is a verb which helps principal verb to form a tense, to form the tense. Okay, and also mood. Look at what is mood. In different ways, verb expresses our feelings. That is the mood of verb. Mood means kriyar bhav. Mood means kriyar bhav. Kriyar bhav. Mood means kriyar bhav. So now I feel, look at example, now I feel, that is you should stay at home. So I want to tell it, do not go out. So that I have written this sentence in imperative mood. Do not go out. So here do auxiliary verb and go principal verb. Do auxiliary verb and go principal verb. So an auxiliary verb is a verb which helps principal verb. So help the principal verb to form a tense here and to form mood or voice. Okay. Now we'll read more about auxiliary verbs.